Well, everyone in Pennington is talking about it. Something smells like weed in that back part of the library.
No one has located the source of the weed smell, but witnesses say that it seems to come from that area of the library behind the computer desk between the magazine rack and that weird couch.
Head librarian Cookie Stevens and library volunteers Margaret Mosier and Gail Fredericks were in the middle of discussing the upcoming used book saleganza when they smelled something strange.
So we smelled marijuana somewhere, and we're like shocked.
Yeah.
And so Doug goes, do you smell it?
Oh, I thought it was my linguine that I left.
It smelled something funny, like it was on fire.
We thought it was Cookie's linguine on fire.
And I couldn't believe it was drugs
in
the library.
Gail knew what it was.
I guessed. It's not like I'm Cheech and Chong or something.
Without any way to confirm that the smell was indeed weed, Cookie Stevens called her husband, Sheriff Stevens, who called in local ceramics teacher Dutch Gibbs, who lived in Seattle for a few months in the 70s.
Yeah, that's weed.
Sheriff Stevens has begun compiling a list of potential suspects, including that boy Lance, who has girl hair and hangs out down by the quarry, Greg Fromke, who was spotted this evening really going to town on some potato skins at Steaky Jake's Steakhouse, and Mr. Thompson. Luckily, one young reading enthusiast seemed unperturbed by the illicit smell.
I hear a lot of people talking about it. I mean, I don't smell anything. I mean, I don't smell anything. I really love the library.
The weed smell comes on the heels of last month's discovery of a gigantic pair of women's underpants in the children's fiction section. According to Stevens, that case remains open as well. Well, too bad it wasn't meth. It just could have had you come down and sniff it out, huh, Kathy?
Eat shit, Randall. I'm in recovery.